And if we're just abstaining from food and drink without realizing the real purpose of the fast, it would be tremendously unfortunate for us. So of course Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and these are things that perhaps you've heard, not once, not twice, not three times, but many, many times. But the idea is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَذَكِّرْ فَإِنَّ ذِكْرَ تَنْفَعُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, remind one another, for verily the reminders benefit the believers. Reminders benefit the believers. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins these ayat of Ramadan. Now very interestingly in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about salah so many times. He talks about charity so many times. He talks about even Hajj in various ayat of the Quran. But the verses of Ramadan come once. The word Ramadan comes once in the Quran. The word Siyam comes only in those particular ayat pertaining to Ramadan. And yet it's so important within our tradition that it's very important that we understand these ayat. We understand these ayat because when Ramadan comes, the Prophet says, إِذَا جَاءَ رَمَضَانُ فُتِّحَتْ أَبْوَابُ الْجَنَّةِ وَغُلِّقَتْ أَبْوَابُ النَّارِ وَصُفِّدَتْ الشَّيَاطِينَ. He says that when the month of Ramadan comes, the gates of paradise are flung open. They're not open, but they're flung open. وَغُلِّقَتْ أَبْوَابُ النَّارِ. And the gates of hellfire are locked shut. وَصُفِّدَتْ الشَّيَاطِينَ. And the shayateen, the devils, are chained. Meaning it becomes very easy to do good deeds. It becomes very easy to stand in qiyam. It becomes very easy to fast. You tell some of your colleagues at work, yeah, I'm not eating or drinking all day in the peak of Arizona summer. You're crazy, right? Some people say that to you. Are you serious? But at least you can drink water, right? And you say, no, I can't even drink water. And they think it's remarkable. But it becomes easy because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enables